السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، إن أصدق حديث كتاب الله عز وجل وأحسن هدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر أمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة كل بدعة دلالة كل دلالة في النار. الحمد لله رب العالمين. All praise is due to Allah عز وجل. We praise him and we extol him. And we seek refuge in Allah from evil within ourselves and evil results of our wrong actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can be led astray. And whomsoever Allah allows to be left in misguidance, there is no guide for that person. Verily, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, and the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the most evil of affairs are the newly invented ones. For verily, every newly invented matter is a bid'ah, a going astray. And every going astray leads to the hellfire. Thumma amma ba'd. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Today, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I would like to speak a little bit about the importance of our iman. Today, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we have noticed that the majority of people nowadays, they are very much more concerned about acquiring wealth and status than acquiring good deeds that will lead to the akhirah. So today, inshallah, I would like to speak about the importance of building and nurturing our iman in and amongst ourselves, bidnillah ta'ala. But first of all, inshallah, I would like to point out a problem in this aspect, a very well-known problem, a common problem, and its solution, bidnillah ta'ala. The majority of people who are finding it very difficult to plant or implant the seeds of iman into their hearts is namely because of fear. Fear of what? Fear of the unseen. Fear of themselves. Fear of their co-workers. Fear of what people might think about them. Fear of what their family might think about them if they started to pray regularly. If they started to show outwardly the deeds of iman, which are, for example, the men starting to grow their beards. And for example, the women's hijabs full-time and their abayas full-time, not only when they go to the masjid or to some Islamic gathering, but that they start to wear their hijabs and their dresses. So this is the first step for the people to implement that seed of faith within our hearts, that we have to overcome fear, fear of the unseen. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I would like us to listen very closely to some of the problems behind the people who have found it difficult to implant these seeds of iman into our heart. The first very well-known problem after they might be overcome the fear is that they do not understand why they're doing those good deeds. Maybe as a result of a person or a brother or a sister calling them to implement their iman, they would only want or they'll start to feel shy when they know that they might be seen by such and such an individual, or when they come back to their homelands. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. This is a commonplace situation, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, that a lot of Muslims, they start to practice Islam, but when they're outside of their locale, where they might see their fellow Muslim brethren, they do not practice Islam as much. But when they come back, they make the excuse that they feel shy. So as a result, they want to practice or show their Islam in front of the people. This is the first starting point, my dear brothers and sisters, in Islam and iman, that we have to develop within ourselves the consciousness to know that the reason why we are practicing our deen is not for the people. Our practicing of Islam is for Allah Azza wa Jal. Why we start to wear our abayas full time for the sisters? Why do the brothers grow their beards or they start to want a regular and frequent going to the masjid? Is not for name or fame. It's not to show off, but for Ridha Rabbul Alameen. So as to please the Lord of the worlds, Allah Azza wa Jal. And as a result, this is as a result, because Allah Azza wa Jal, He's calling us to iman. Allah Azza wa Jal's Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was sent to call all of mankind to iman. So as a result of us developing this consciousness that we are doing whatever it is that we're doing for Allah's sake, then as a result, Allah Azza wa Jal will bless us. Allah Azza wa Jal will bless our families. Allah Azza wa Jal, He will bless our surroundings. And then Allah Azza wa Jal will bless us inwardly to develop a sense of higher consciousness. We'll start to develop a higher sense of being. We'll start to develop a sense of empathy for our fellow men. So when we interact with each other, then we'll feel a sense of compassion towards those not so practicing Muslims. And those people who are non-Muslims will be more empathetic towards them not being guided to having this favor of Iman. So which, as a result of us, Allah Azza wa Jalla blessing us with that higher sense of consciousness, there's another level of consciousness what Allah Azza wa Jalla will bless us with. And this only comes when we first, our first starting point is that when we do things, we do it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So for us to get into that first step of doing something, of practicing our deen, we have to first and foremost know that we are not doing it for show. We're not doing it for anybody, but we're doing it for Ridha Rabbil Alameen, for the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal. So as a result, Allah Azza wa Jal will bless us with a higher consciousness. And then after that, Allah Azza wa Jal will bless us with a sense called a maraqaba, a higher sense of consciousness, which is that we'll develop within ourselves, is that we'll understand and we'll know that Allah is always watching over us. We will not have that sense that we are fearful of the results of our actions towards the people, but we'll be more fearful that we're disobeying Allah Azza wa Jal, and we'll be disobeying Allah in regards to the khalq, because there's a different level in everything that we do. There is a level of dealing with the people, a mu'amalat. That is that we are interactions, our daily interactions amongst ourselves. And there is a level of ibadat, which is our interactions with Allah, Rabbul Alameen. And we cannot see Allah. When we have to develop a higher sense of consciousness by first, when that first, putting our first step in that direction of knowing that whatever we do, we're doing it for Ridha Rabbil Alameen. If a person were to call us to show us our mistakes or our misgivings or our misunderstandings or showing us that it's important to pray, we are going to pray not because of that person. We are going to be thankful that Allah will just send us that person to show us the way. And we appreciate that person and we pray for that person. But ultimately, it's by the tawfiq of Allah. So when we have a willingness to want to implement the Iman, when we have a willingness of wanting to plant the seed of Iman, of faith into our hearts, then as a result, that willingness will develop into a higher sense of maraqaba, a higher sense of knowing that Allah, a higher sense of Allah consciousness. And as a result of Allah Azza wa Jal blessing us with that higher sense of consciousness, then Allah Azza wa Jal will bless us, will make us one of the muhsinin. This is as occurred in the hadith of Jibreel alayhi salam, where Jibreel alayhi salam came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam and asked him about Islam, about Iman and Islam and the Ihsan. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi salam answered him when he came to the question of Ihsan. He says that we should abudullah ka'annahu tara, that we are worshipping Allah as if we see Allah. فَلَمْ تَقُنْ تَرَاهُ إِنْهُ يَرَاكَ. And if we cannot develop that sense that we are worshipping Allah as if we are seeing Allah in front of us, then we have to know that Allah Azza wa Jal is always watching us. So who is it that has that? Who is it that can reach that state of consciousness, as the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that in the answer of Ihsan, that we worship Allah as if we're seeing Allah? That is something that is completely unaware. It's something that is completely unachievable by the majority of human beings. But we can worship Allah knowing that Allah Azza wa Jal is always watching us. That Allah Azza wa Jal is always watching over us. We should have this taqwa of Allah and have that higher sense of Allah, of this maraqaba, So as develop into the muhsinin, those who have the ihsan, that when we do things out of love for Allah. We're doing things that we're knowing that we're doing these deeds because Allah Azza wa Jalla is watching over us, and He will give us, He has given us the tawfiq in that regard. He's given us the ability to do those good deeds for what? Ridha Rabbil Alameen. So whatever we do, we have the sense of taqwa. As the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in another authentic hadith, that we should have this consciousness of Allah. We should have this fear or knowing that Allah Azza wa Jal is watching us, and that when wherever we do and wherever we go, that we should always deal with ourselves and deal with the people in a higher sense. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, with this in mind, I would like to mention an ayah, two ayah, which is in Surah Araf, ayah number 42 and 43, where Allah Azza wa Jalla describes the state of the believers when they are entering into Al-Jannah. But despite that, Allah Azza wa Jalla describes the state of the believers, but despite that, Allah Azza wa Jalla attaches to that one catch, or seemingly small thing, which will prevent the believers who have done the good deeds from entering into paradise. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلَ الصَّالِحَاتِ لَا نُكَلِّفُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا أُولَئِكَ أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِم مِّنَ الْغِلِّ تجري من تحتهم الأنهار وقال الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله لقد جاءت رسول ربنا بالحق ونودوا أن تلقم الجنة أورثتموها بما كنتم تعملون. But those who believed, listen closely what Allah Azza wa Jalla says in His book, but those who believed and worked righteousness, work righteous good deeds, we do not burden any person beyond their scope. Such are the dwellers of paradise. They will abide therein, and we shall remove from their hearts, from their chest, an ighil, rivers flowing underneath them, and they will say, all praise and thanks is due to Allah who has guided us to this, and never could we have found this guidance were it not that Allah had guided us. Indeed, the messengers of our Lord did come with the truth, and it will be a cry to them. It will be cried out to them. This is the paradise which you have inherited for that which you used to do. Here, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam and Iman, Allah Azza wa Jal is clearly showing to us the meaning of which in these sets of ayats, the conditions of those who will be contented with their Lord and well pleased with Allah for being granted Al-Jannah by saying Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana lihada. All praise is due to Allah for guiding us to this. وَمَا كُنَّا لِنَهْتَدِي لَوْلَا أَنْ هَدَانَ اللَّهِ. And we would have never been guided to do these righteous good deeds if it were not that Allah Azza wa Jal guided us to these deeds. The Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says in an authentic hadith that none of us will be granted Al-Jannah because of our deeds. And they said, قِيلَ وَلَّا أَنْتِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Not even you, Ya Rasulullah. The Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, not even me, unless Allah Azza wa Jal grants me His Jannah out of His mercy and His favor. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وسلم من تبعه وبعد. ما شاء الله تبارك الله. For whomsoever Allah Azza wa Jal had granted the tawfiq, which is the ability and the aptitude to understand and to practice the deeds. ما شاء الله تبارك الله. May Allah be pleased with all of you and all of us. Ameen. But we have to keep one thing firm in our minds, is that us being able to do these deeds, these righteous deeds, is all coming from the tawfiq and the grant and the ability given by Allah Rabbul Alameen. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, if we were to believe that it's because of our level of piety why Allah Azza wa Jal granted this, is not that. If Allah blesses us and gives us the desire to do it, then we have to constantly thank and praise Allah for that thing. If Allah Azza wa Jal sends us somebody to help us and to explain something which we did not understand, then fi dhahr al-ghayb, behind our brother's back, we should make dua for that person. We should make dua for that person, that Allah bless that person for Allah Azza wa Jal sending them to us. But as Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in this blessed set of ayats, that وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنَ الْغِلِ, that Allah Azza wa Jal will not grant us that Jannah. How much deeds we've done, that in accordance with the Quran and Sunnah, if we are a grudgeful people, Allah Azza wa Jal will not grant us, and we will not be able to inherit the Jannah if we are a grudgeful people. We cannot ever expect to enter into Jannah, I'll repeat that thrice, if we hold grudges in our hearts. We cannot control the hearts of mankind. And we can hardly ever control our own hearts. And we can hardly control our own thoughts and our minds. But one thing we can do is to forgive and forget. If we ever expect Allah Azza wa Jal to grant us the Jannah, then we have to know from this blessed ayah and many a hadith of the Rasulullah ﷺ that the Jannah will not be inherited no matter how much good deeds you do, no matter how much you spend in the path of Allah. If you are a person who holds grudges, if you hold this animosity in your heart, you will not be entered Jannah. This is something that we have to understand, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. As Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنَ الْغِلِ. This ghil is something that is a little taint. It's something that we cannot forget, we cannot let go of. It's a thought that we can never let go of. We say, you know what? I forgive the brother, or I forgive the sister, but I just can't bring myself to forget what they've done to me. I can't bring myself to forget it. This is what we have to do, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam and Iman. If we really want the Jannah, then we have to bring ourselves to that higher level of consciousness and bring ourselves to forgive and forget. This is the real meaning of forgiveness. If we want Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive us and overlook and look as if we did not commit those deeds, then we have to be in the habit. We have to first be as that. We have to be that type of a person, that type of an individual, because that is the mu'amalat. We're going to be dealing with people. We're going to be interacting with people. But until and unless we can get over our grievances, our petty grievances, whether it is about money or any other things that we might assume that a brother or sister did intentionally or purposely, forgive and forget. Forgive and forget. This is what we have to bring ourselves to. If we want to be of those people who Allah Azza wa Jalla calls al-muhsineen, the people who are the people of ihsan, then we have to bring ourselves to the higher level of consciousness. Because these petty things will, as a result, as much good deeds that we have accumulated, will prevent us from entering into Jannah. Allah Azza wa Jalla says about the disbelievers, fi qulubihim marad. The disbelievers are those people who hold grudges in their heart. Fi qulubihim maradan, Allah Azza wa Jalla says. The kuffar, the disbelievers, ones who do not believe in Allah, they are the ones who hold within themselves grudges. They, as a result of holding grudges, their hearts have developed a disease. Nasallahu al-afiyah. So if we want Allah Azza wa Jalla to bless us in this life and ultimately grant us out of His mercy, not out of our amal, His Jannah, then we have to remove this ghil from our hearts. We'll not be able to enter into Jannah if we have a grudge, if we're holding grudges and not wanting to overlook things that happen between our brothers and sisters in Islam. So as Allah Azza wa Jalla says in another ayah, a beautiful ayah, وَمَنْ يُحْقَ شُحَّ نَفْسِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمَ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. And whoever is saved from their own shuh, greed and wanting for themselves, then they are those who are the successful ones. With that in mind, there is an authentic hadith on the authority of Ikrama bin Abu Jahl and two other wounded people, fighters, who were fighting in a battle, and they were injured in the battle of Yarmouk. And each one of them had a very serious injury, and they were offered water. They were offered water. And each one of them thought that their brother is more entitled to the water than themselves. They passed the water to the other brother. They said, give it to the other brother. And the other brother gave it to the other brother. And when the water returned back, the other person passed away. And when the other person was offered the water, they passed away. So this, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, is the state, this was the state of Ashab Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They were those who always considered the thoughts and feelings of others over themselves. They weren't the ones who would hold grudges or to think about themselves before other people. They would always take into consideration the feelings and thoughts and emotions of others. The Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and Ashab Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they were very, very meticulous and sensitive to that point that they did not want to harm or offend any of the makhlukat. It occurs in a hadith, authentic hadith, that when the Prophet Dawood Alayhi Salaam was bitten one day by an ant, he, as a result, burnt down the whole anthill. Allah Azza wa Jal reprimanded the Prophet Dawood Alayhi Salaam and he said, wasn't it only one ant? Wasn't it only one ant that did that to you? So this, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, should make us understand that if one person did something to us, there's no means to hold a grudge against the whole nation. If one individual did something to us that we dislike, it doesn't mean that we should be grudgeful or resentful and dislike that whole nation of people because of the actions of one individual. Forgive that person. Forgive that sister. Forgive that brother. And we have to learn to do this. We have to train ourselves to do this. If we hear a brother starting to sing a song about how much they hate these people, how is it? Why is it? You cannot know a whole nation of people. Maybe one or two people rubbed you the wrong way. So it's not for us to hate a whole nation or to despise a whole nation because of the actions of a few. When we develop this within ourselves, then Allah Azza wa Jalla will bless us. We will feel the blessing in our life. This is the attitude of the Muhsinin, that they don't hold grudges. They are those who forgive and forget. So this, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, when we're doing our good deeds, we have to always keep in mind that while we're doing this, Allah Azza wa Jalla had blessed us with the tawfiq. Allah Azza wa Jalla blessed us. And remember, it's not how much you do, but it is how good you do it. Ahsanu amal. Ayyukum ahsanu amal, Allah Azza wa Jalla says. That Allah Azza wa Jalla wants to find out which ones of us are the best at doing good deeds. Not the one who can do the most good deeds, but those of us who are best at doing good deeds. However little our good deeds may be, we should try our best and perfect it. Whatever deed we're doing, we should try and develop our sense of perfection. That is where we become one of the muhsinin, bidhni Allah ta'ala. And while we're doing that, we have to remember, always keep in our mind, that is by the tawfiq of Allah Azza wa Jal. It is the grant given by Allah Azza wa Jal that He blessed us with the ability to be able to do these good deeds. And while we're doing these good deeds, we have to always keep in mind that we have to deal with other people. We cannot seclude or isolate ourselves from the mukhlukat, from the creation, from Allah's creation, the human beings, the ants, the animals. We have to remember that everybody has a right. Everybody on the planet Earth has a right. And we should not count out everybody because of the actions of a few. As the Rasulullah said about one person was granted Jannah because of a dog, and one was granted the hell because of a cat. One was granted the Jannah because of a dog, that this person, they say, was a lady. She went down into a well and she drank water and she quenched her thirst. And as coming out of the well, she seen a very thirsty dog licking on the dirt. And she remembered how much thirst she was in, how much suffering she was going through. So she went back down into the well and brought out the water from the well with her slipper or her shoe and gave that thirsty dog a drink. And another lady was granted the nar, who was a very pious lady in some narration, because of a cat. She kept the cat locked up into the closet and didn't allow the cat to go out and roam and get the food from the earth. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let us grant and give everybody who deserves a right its right. May Allah bless us and grant us the tawfiq to understand that whatever Allah has blessed us with, this is a grant given by Allah, and we should thank Allah for that and try and be kind to the people so Allah will be kind and merciful towards us. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلم تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وقنا الصلاة
So make a line straight. Don't leave any gap for the shaitan. Kids, make a line straight.